successfully breached the Great Wall of China. He led his forces to the greatest prize in the East, the capital city of Zhongdu. He besieged the city, knowing that its inhabitants could not hold out forever. Bearing down on the gleaming capital of Zhongdu, Genghis Khan raised the black banner of war on his historic enemy, the Qin Dynasty. To take the heavily garrisoned capital, the Mongols would have to starve its army by eliminating Chengdu's suppliers. But first, the Khan directed his warriors to raid Qin buildings and villages surrounding Chengdu. Word of the army's wealth would spread, compelling Mongol soldiers from the north to join the fight, seeking spoils of their own.
Yeah.
Hearing of the Khan's successful raids, Mongol settlers and soldiers arrived to join his army. With his numbers steadily growing, the Khan turned his attention to the capital. He sought to starve Chengdu's army by cutting off its suppliers. A Qin trader made it safely into the city, and reported on the Mongols' numbers and movements. Chengdu would now allocate any military supplies it received to rallying counterattacks on the steppe invaders. Struck down the trader that was headed to resupply Chengdu. For every trader killed, Chengdu lost several days' worth of supplies. The Mongols were systematically choking the city and starving its garrison. Despite the Mongols' efforts to stop them, enough Qin traders had entered Chengdu to fully resupply its military. Choosing their moment, the Qin launched a counterattack.
Thank you.
The Mongols put down the Qin counterattack. But another would soon come if Qin traders continued to resupply Chengdu's military.
Yeah, you're right.
The Mongols left the Shunyi market in ruins, ensuring the village could no longer send supplies to Zhongdu. In destroying the supplying markets, the Mongols denied Zhongdu critical supplies, leaving its garrison weakened. As the Mongols continued to sabotage the city's supplies, Chengdu's garrison grew weaker by the day. Despite the Mongols' efforts to stop them, enough Qin traders had entered Chengdu to fully resupply its military. Choosing their moment, the Qin launched a counterattack.
Jack, жарлаг буулгах гэж байна м.
Цугаар бит гişүү тэмгэж байна м.
Цугаар гэл. Жа, Эрдэнэ малтаж байна м.
Get the big hat so. Beach, good way so.
I just put it, Benham. Be you good way so.
Yelkum Kosak.
So far, beat. Ja, it's not much that you buy him. Махан авчирсуу.
Бидэг.
Ээ бидэг. Эхээ, мах тавайж.
Тата бат.
Это мой путь!
Despite the Mongols' efforts to stop them, enough Qin traders had entered Zhongdu to fully resupply its military. Choosing their moment, the Qin launched a counterattack. The market at Tongzhou was set aflame, and with it many vital supplies intended for the city.
Yeah.
Without hesitation, the Khan's warriors put their torches to the market at Darsing, snuffing out weeks of Chongdu's supplies. With Chongdu devastated by starvation, the walls of the great Qin capital were devoid of soldiers, and only a diminished garrison remained. Desperate and isolated, Zhongdu could no longer resist. The time had come for Genghis Khan to launch his assault on the city.
Get the guy what's up?
Unleashed the wrath of his Mongol warriors on the heart of the beleaguered city.
Come on.
The Qin monument was put to flame. Mongol victory was within reach. The city was ready to fall in the wake of the destruction wrought by the Mongols. Zhongdu fell to the wrath of Genghis Khan's warriors, yielding great riches for the Mongol Empire. The sacking of Zhongdu would be remembered as one of Genghis Khan's most devastating victories. But this was just the beginning of his quest to create a global empire under Mongol rule.